Hi there. My name's David of Chegg 472 Food Science and Technology, and I'm here to talk about fermentation. When it comes to cooking, food, and biology, fermentation is everywhere. In the things we eat, the things we drink, and even in ourselves. But what is fermentation? Basically, fermentation is a reaction that yeasts, bacteria, and cells perform when they consume food, namely sugar. The central food-based fermentation reaction looks like this. Glucose goes to ethanol and carbon dioxide. When these things are in the presence of glucose, they will naturally consume it to produce ethanol and carbon dioxide. These are not the only products of fermentation, though. Side reactions that also occur during fermentation produce things like lactic and acetic acids, for example, which are much more sour, tangy flavors. Sometimes this is a good thing, other times, not so much. An important note is that fermentation occurs best whenever there is minimal oxygen in the system and minimal light added to the system. We can see this in ourselves. As many biologists and athletes will tell you, it's important to breathe when you exercise. This is because the breathing adds oxygen, allowing your cells to undergo cellular respiration instead of lactic acid fermentation, since the latter causes muscle soreness the next day. But let's talk about food. What foods do we eat that are fermented? Here's a short list for you. Beer, sourdough bread, yogurt, wine, soy sauce, kombucha, kimchi, sauerkraut, cheese, pickles, miso, vinegar, and so on. In every single one of these foods or drinks, we allow yeast, natural or otherwise, to act on some type of sugar in a low oxygen environment, producing some combination of ethanol, carbon dioxide, lactic acid, and so on. So what's the buzz about fermented food? The one-word answer is probiotics, bacteria and yeast that are good for you. These bacteria and yeasts are considered helpful for digestion and immune systems, the reason for which is often considered to be competition for resources with bacteria that's not good for you. Fermentation has always been with us, with food. The first beers and wines were made with wild yeast strains over 10,000 years ago in Jiahu, China, and your favorite beers and wines today are still made with the same yeast. Thanks for watching my video on fermentation science.